Perhaps the strongest U.S. player is going to go nose-to-nose with Big Perez. There they go.
Bench goal to the left, empty. Hennigan and Perez poking at one another at the edge of the circle. Hennigan stepped into Perez. The French have the puck. Couturier missed Beal with the pass. It's got Beal at the faceoff dot. Centers one. Weak shot. Another shot is broken up by Sweeney. 10 seconds left. Here's Couturier at the blue line. The drive turned aside by Ray LeBlanc. The U.S. couldn't clear it out, but now the puck comes off the board. One more shot by Couturier. Misses. It's all over. Ray LeBlanc, congratulated by his teammates after the big salute. And a scuffle is going on at the blue line as the two teams meet.
Yeah, this baby ain't over yet, unfortunately. Couturier for the French. Clark Donatelli, who came off the bench for Team USA. And at this stage, nothing can be gained. Time to conserve adrenaline, guys. The war has been won. Don't bother turning the hands of time back to the battle.
Now the French outshot the U.S. by a wide margin. Just a little more than 2-1 on the game. 35 shots by France, 17 by the U.S. It's been that way throughout. Linesman will try to get the chip separated here. A couple of the French players are not going to stay around for a handshake. More than handshakes going on. And no doubt the U.S. will be criticized heavily in the papers here tomorrow. The official mascot out on the ice, he'll play goal. He looks a great deal like Skip Carey, but be that as it may. Uh-oh, Sackle put the stick up over the glass toward a fan who was bothering him. You're not seeing it. Again, I remind you, we share the coverage with the French. But it's all over here. They can do what they like, say what they like. The United States has taken the next step. They have won it 4-1. Now back to Nick Charles in Atlanta.